I think she said he was older than Andrew. She found him boring, very serious. Sorry, I don't know much about him, other than that Moira met him a couple of times. The first time was on a weekend trip to Aviemore, and again the weekend she flirted with Elspeth's boyfriend, Piers. She'd gone to Edinburgh with Andrew, but had to come home early because Hans turned up. If I remember rightly, she said Hans was having personal trouble, and being his cousin, Andrew felt obliged to spend extra time with him. Why was Hans even in Edinburgh at the time? Surely he wouldn't have flown to Edinburgh just to discuss his personal problems with Kelso. It's much more likely that he was in the country already. Was he a delegate at the conference too? Did he live in Scotland? Sorry, no idea. I'm not being much help, am I? On the contrary, you picked up on the coincidence of the dog's name. We have a new avenue of investigation to pursue. Another possible suspect. He pauses. That's if we assume it's more than coincidence that Hans was known to Menzies as well as Kelso and Moira. Our eyes meet. I have one of my lightbulb moments. What if Hans is our mystery man? The one Lucy saw speaking with Moira the afternoon she disappeared. No doubt he was ahead of me with this. Is there some way to check Andrew's family background to find out the surname of the German branch of the family? I ask. The simplest way would probably be to ask his ex-wife, but she might blab to Andrew. She's Annie Calder these days. I'll contact her tomorrow, see if she'll agree to talk to us, Innes says. And we need to speak with Piers Thornton. He looks thoughtful. Did Thornton know Hans, I wonder? Given that they both knew Kelso, it's a possibility.